we just keep hearing this finale is like a game changer, a crowd pleaser.
They won't let me know about it. No, I'm kidding. Because I blew the finale last year, if you guys know that. Oh, I went to WonderCon. Yeah. Nice. I shouldn't tell you this, because then you'll ask me questions, because you'll know that I'll give up answers. But uh-huh. A fan just was peppering me with questions and peppering me with questions. And then her last question was, so the brother, he's going to be okay, right? And I was like, yeah. And then and Mom looked at me and was like, what did you just say? And I thought, oh, my God. But she like, Johnny Cochran to me. Like, she was just on it and on it and on it. And there was nothing I could do. So now you know what you can do to get answers. Don't do that.
Okay, but it has been described as a crowd pleaser by more than one of your cast. So how do you define that?
I don't know how... that wasn't how I was... I would just say I found it to be kind of shocking to me. I was like, what? We're doing this. Oh, thank you. Table service. Hello. I found it shocking more than... I think people will be pleased at being shocked, but to me a crowd pleaser is more peppy.
Okay.
You know, like to me, what's a crowd pleaser? What's that movie that was? Oh, Deadpool. That's a crowd pleaser. I guess that's not really. That's a lot of violence too. So I don't know. Yeah, you'll be pleased in a crowd and surprised personally.
Okay.
Well, we know that at the end of the season you kind of veer away from the procedural style of the episode.
Just for two episodes.
Well, that's what I was wondering is if was it signaling a change in the way you tell the story for next season, or is procedural always part of it?
God, that procedural is like a gift from God. You don't want to get rid of that. No, not until you have to. They will pry that procedural out of my cold dead hand or my animated undead hand.
But could you see the show taking more risks and kind of moving away from the procedural?
I think like this, like at the end where something is built up and you don't have time for it, yes, but on a week to week, just doing that for what? I mean, eventually, you know, season six, when, you know, if zombies progress enough to the fact that I don't think you have time for, you know, regular murders, because everyone's being murdered by zombies, maybe you don't have a kid. I wonder who did it. It was a zombie. Pretty sure it was a zombie.
What was fun then to break from the format and raise the action bar and do all those things that you get to do to kind of knock it out of the park in the last episode?
Was that fun?
What was the fun of it for you, like figuring out?
It was really stressful for me because Rob had, for when we got to like 2:18, well, luckily they're airing back to back. I don't know if you know that. Did you know that? There is a 2-hour finale, so it's 2:18 and 2:19 are airing back to back. So originally 2:18 was more, not cerebral, but there's less action. There's a lot happening. There's a ton happening, but it's not very actiony. But now together, it's like, whoa, so much is happening. But it was hard to, you know, Rob had this idea of what he wanted for the finale, and he wanted these, you know, action sequences, but then he gave it to me to write. So then I was like, oh my God. So it was, well, me and Kit, Boss, and Rob, we all wrote it together, but there were some scenes that he handed me that were these really heavy action scenes, and so it was a little daunting, but yeah, because we don't get to do that much action, so, you know, calling production and saying, can we have like 90 fight sequences this episode? That's cool, right? So, yeah.
What can you say about where you're leaving Liv by the end of the season?
We're leaving her primed for a comeback in season 3. We're leaving her in a way that you'll really want to come back in season 3 and see what is going to happen with her.
Are you considering changing the format from the weekly procedural mystery?
No, I'm not, unless Rob told you different. But I don't think so. I think that, much like I was saying, with the occasional... Today, this episode is a special episode, so we don't... It's the finale, or it's a mid-season finale, so we don't have a procedural.
The
special episode, perhaps, but for the most part, next season we'll have procedurals. Unless Rob just went to Turks and Caicos, wherever the hell he went, and just went, you know what, screw it. Then maybe.
Do you have any brain ideas that you've had to hold back?
Yes, and I'm saying it up to everyone because I want Rob to do it. He refuses. I want to do a hockey goon so bad. Like
what?
A hockey goon, a hockey enforcer.
Oh.
And Rob just puts the kibosh on it every time. So I feel like you guys should really want to see that and just write about how badly you want to see a hockey goon.
You can do basketball, but not hockey.
Hi. My sport, basketball, is Rob's sport.
Ah, there we go. Now we understand.
It works. I'd have to explain icing to him prior to the episode, so... Yeah, I know nothing about basketball.
Can you tease us some of the brain dishes that we can look forward to seeing?
Like, in season three?
As we run toward the end of the season, some of the recipes that...
Oh my god, I cannot think of a single recipe. I can't think of a single...
Super snacks.
Yeah, super snacks. I wrote that one and I can't remember what she eats. I know that we were talking about how it's strip clubs, apparently. Honey, is it true at strip clubs they have a buffet?
They do.
There are some strip clubs. I've read.
We were trying to figure out how to do that, like, strip club buffet with the brain, and we couldn't figure that out. But what did we wind up doing? Oh, we did a... It's a club sandwich, like a strip club sandwich. But not the best, but... Yeah, but yeah, I know, we're so cheeky, it's annoying, but people seem to love the brain cooking.
Yeah, which is good.
Well, I'm a big fan of, like the Downton Abbey finale. Let's make, let's have little cucumber sandwiches on, you know what I mean? Like, I like eating on theme, so her eating on theme for the episode, I feel, is pretty on point.
Well, and the iZombie cookbook is like a natural, like, franchise builder.
I have not done an interview where people haven't mentioned the iZombie cookbook. I feel like I should just write it while Rob is busy and just be like, I wrote this book.